And now for news from around the world. And meanwhile, in meanwhile, in Brazil, or at least formerly in Brazil, Jair Bolsonaro has pulled the most Trumpy move imaginable. His successor, Lula da Silva, is being inaugurated, but he's not there. He fled. And he didn't just flee an inauguration, which would be Trumpy enough. He did it exactly as Trump would. He took a trip to Florida to hang out with an MMA fighter. Former president of Brazil is doing this. He flew there on Friday, plans to stay there at least a month, coincidentally as multiple investigations into him continue. He's staying in a rented home owned by a professional mixed martial artist fighter, just miles from Disney World. Maybe he'll fill some of his time going on the rides. I hear Epcot's a lot of fun. Anyway, the tradition is supposed to be that he would pass a presidential sash to Lula on the ceremony back on Sunday. It's supposed to symbolize a peaceful transition of power. And I'm sure that's a big part of why he didn't want to do it. In the same way that Donald Trump wasn't going to participate in Biden's inauguration, despite the fact that the election was fairly won, he is refusing to actually acquiesce to that, to put his stamp of approval and potentially tamp down some of the fervor amongst his supporters by participating in it as he was supposed to. And the inquiries I was talking about, there's five of them, by the way, includes an investigation into his misinformation laden attacks on the voting machines in Brazil. Another into his possible links to digital militias that spread misinformation. This is similar, in fact, to what Donald Trump was doing following his loss. So anyway, Mondale, I just think it's hilarious that like the, you know, like South America's Trump is staying South America's Trump.
The similarities are too, you couldn't write this in a movie. People wouldn't believe it. This is this is unbelievable. People are, and I mean, you know, Trump and Bolsonaro, the idea that democracy means nothing to these guys and they were in power at the same time is unbelievable and creepy. It speaks to, had someone had more, you know, political acumen, they would be dangerous. So the next version of these two gentlemen will be way more dangerous because they will have seen what is possible from these two, and also understanding the systems, what you can do. I am super nervous by this idea, and it seems funny. It seems like it's just perfunctory, but it's not. Like, you walked away from a tradition that says our government is changing peacefully. So this is not just a ceremony. This is actually the transitioning of a democracy. And I think it sends the wrong signal, not just to people in Brazil, just for other lunatics around the world that think and see the world like Donald Trump and Bolsonaro. And I'm afraid what, like I said, the next iteration is someone who understands government that sees it just like them will be way more dangerous than these two guys. And it's unbelievable. Yeah. That he's with an MMA fighter right now is unbelievable to me for so many reasons. Like, you, these guys lose violently in fights and they stand and raise their hands with the person who just defeated them. And you can't even stand and let the winner get his verbal hand raised. I am disgusted by the fact that you chose to be with an MMA fighter right now.
100%. There's that one fun part. The rest of it, not great. And the similarities are so good. You have the rough years while the authoritarian leader's in charge. They're rejected by the voters, and that is good news. But they are doing whatever they can in their limited capacity to set the stage for more and more of the people of their country to lose faith in democracy, to look for the next person who, as you say, might understand the process or understand government a little bit better, might be more willing to push for explicit violence. And so while, you know, we have these two wins in these two different countries, we do have to be worried about the future. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.